Before I became a TV presenter, I used to work here in the City of London. I was a business analyst specialising in Dutch banks and banking, and obviously knew all the key players in the market. But now it seems there's a new presence. They're called Rabo Development, they're Dutch, and they're doing great things in Zambia of all places. They sound intriguing, and I'm keen to learn more. So let's go see for ourselves. Rabo Development is fairly new and exciting. Its roots go back a long way. It says here that they're part of Rabobank Group, which I know is a very old and well-respected Dutch cooperative bank. They've been around for more than a century, and they're solid, very solid. I think their goal has always been to make finance accessible to all, not just the urban elite, and it seems like they're still doing the same thing, not only in Holland, but all over the world. And so they look like they're pretty well equipped for the job. They're experts in agriculture and they have a good understanding of how rural communities work. Their experience in starting from scratch and building from there. They have the technology that banks need nowadays. And perhaps most importantly of all, they seem to be genuinely interested in accelerating the development of the underprivileged. You put all that together and you do get a nicely balanced picture. Downtown Lusaka, a sprawling city with over 1 million inhabitants, is also the capital of Zambia. Zambia is a country that's traditionally been reliant on a huge copper industry, but it's had to shift its focus ever since prices started falling in the 70s and continue to drop. Today, the future of the country depends on agriculture, and there's a lot of potential there, with only a fifth of the country currently cultivated. But how do you turn that potential into productivity? At least part of that answer lies in banking, which is why I'm here to meet Mark Wiesing and Edward Metal of Zanarco. Until recently, Zanarco was a state-owned bank, but now Rabobank owns 45% of it, and it calls itself big, strong, and reliable.
Well, we were very interested in Zambia for a number of reasons. The country is politically stable, it has a fairly resilient economy, and it has also a strong agricultural sector that is a large component of the country's economy.
So initially, we thought the Rabo was just like another commercial bank. But the Rabo is a commercial bank with a difference, I think, in my opinion. Well, Rabo doesn't emphasize on profitability, though profit is necessary for sustainability. But service is more important than the profitability. So that there was a synergy between why the bank was set up initially and the Rabo's model of doing business.
We compete against Barclays, Standard Chartered, Standard Bank of South Africa, Citibank.
But for us to be competitive, we need to change the mindset of the staff so that we can be outward looking in terms of customer service and customer focus.
And focused on very specific and chosen segments that exist in the Zambian economy.
We've got to know each segment of our customers and what they need. And a big chunk of our segmentation is our rural customers.
And Zanarco was a bank with a strong rural network.
We are probably the only bank with ATMs in every provincial town in the country. We are found in every district.
We had about 30 machines 2 years ago, and we are now close to 100 installed machines. We have actually also benefited from gifts of used machines from the local Rabobanks in the Netherlands.
Since 1969, Zanaco prides itself in being close to the people of Zambia through provision of banking services nationwide.
We use the media, okay, radio, television.
The Zambia Privatization Trust Fund and Zanaco will be offering Zanaco shares to the public. Now you can own your bank by buying Zanaco shares.
We actually sold shares in Zanaco to the Zambian public, because we feel that if we want to be the people's bank, we also need to have a direct link with those people through, for instance, an ownership structure. One of the successes that we have achieved in reaching out to the unbanked is through the launch of mobile banking in Zambia.
You can make payments on the phone, like utility bills, water, electricity, telephone. You can check your balances. You can even check your transaction. So that makes the banking easy.
This mobile banking product, we call it Zapit Instant Banking. And we are able to offer this product to customers without them having to come to our branch.
You can go up to the marketplace, give you a brief demonstration, and people can open an account there by feeding in a form just on the spot.
We can offer on the spot a Visa card, which we activate on the spot. We take pictures of these people as identity check, which are uploaded to our central systems. And we activate their mobile banking also on the spot, remotely outside of the branch. There's probably 800,000 people in Zambia with bank accounts, but there's 3 or 4 million people with cell phones.
Within 1 year from when Rabo took over, the bank is recognized by everyone in terms of its financial competitiveness, in terms of its product, and even in terms of its service.
This is not about an overnight significant financial improvement. This is actually about building the bank of the future, the Zambian bank of the future for Zambians for the long term.
So the bankers seem pretty pleased with what they've achieved, and it does sound good, but what about the government? It was their bank after all. Are they happy with how things are going?